Hello for Tuesday, July 24th, and the market pulled back some more, about 100 points drop. It dropped further, but had a pretty good buy point. We'll see in a moment. You can see here on the cash chart as well, it came down in this trend line. Is it going to continue down? Well, the volume was less, but it was pretty high for a Monday. Mondays have been pretty weak, and so there was quite a lot of selling still. It's closed under the 20-day moving average and 50-day EMA, but above the 200. It could come down actually and test again. From the June low, we came up above the 200, then came down and tested it once for the little rally at the end of June, then came down again and tested it, and then last week's rally back up again. And of course, all three of these times, 12.898, 12.961, 12.977, it can't break out of this range. Once it does, then I think everyone's going to figure we're going to make, at least going to test the highs of the year and maybe go on to make new ones. But it's summertime and we could break down and test the lows again. So you're just going to have to take it as it comes when it's in this little range like this. If it breaks out, it could be shorted under 12,531. And then we've got 492, of course, but we could come back down. Anyway, that's the... There's no big prediction here other than at the moment it's above the trend line, so it could go back up. We'll look at the futures in a minute. SPX here is also at a trend line right there. You can see a rough trend line. Also, it closed back up over its 50-day EMA, a little bit under the 20-day, but not that much. Also, a little lower volume, but pretty high for a Monday. So the same thing holds true here, is that for the Dow. Maybe we can just reverse back up. Well, it's earnings time still, so we've got a lot of companies to report. And if things change and people have some surprises at the upside or some good news, maybe we could rally once again, but that's yet to come. Apple does report. In fact, we'll show the chart in a minute and make a comment about that. The Russell, we've been talking that this may come back down to its trend line. Didn't quite get there, but you can see with the gap down, excuse me, it went down to the 200-day EMA and closed a little bit underneath it, 779 and change, and it closed at 778 and almost 779. So 50 cents below the 200-day, not a lot. If it comes down much further, we'll want to see it hold this trend line. If not, it's probably going to the lower Bollinger Band. But holding that could be a bounce buy right there. RSI doesn't necessarily have to get back under 30 once again. We could bounce anyway from there. And, of course, the Williams indicator is about midstream at the moment, a little bit under. Now it's 51, so a point underneath it. Anyway, this gapping down after a pretty good run-up, pullback, run back up to this 808 resistance, pull back again. So let's see if we can do it one more time. Gold, we said in the newsletter, not a very interesting time for gold, actually. Although, as far as the shorts go, here you can see what gold did today. We won't show more of that chart. It's not really interesting. Although GDX did drop more, and of course we're short the GDX, this mechanical trade. So it's not a question of judgment, it's just a question of what the chart tells us, and it's been short quite a while now, above this about 45 area, and right now it closed at the 40.70, so up about 4.5 points on it, on the downside. And you can take profits as it comes down, if you like, and then when it reverses, because it doesn't reverse instantly, you know, it's going to go up and you're going to lose a point going up on the upside. And anyway, just be prepared. And SLV has not really changed. It's still in the short, and it's really totally uninteresting. I wouldn't bother to be in it until it starts picking up some volatility. But GDX is okay because it continues to do pretty well. We'll get to that in just a second. These are additions to the watch list and what happened. But first, let's switch back here to the futures. I'm just going to show a couple of them. It's kind of late in the day already. I'm just waiting for it to come. There, it's starting. I can see a flicker. This is the Dow, and this one we posted because at the morning, it was right here at the 61.8 and also at the pivot, and it looked like, well, it's possible. We wrote that you can see on this first candle here, this is a 60-minute chart, we said it's trying a bounce at the 61.8. Well, trying it, couldn't, and then it failed, so that was a fine short right there, because you can look left and see that there, that next support is down here near the 786 retracement. 786 is a pretty good number. And Also, you're not seeing that this is the new session pivot points, but S3 was right there as well, right at the 78.6, so this is just a perfect spot. And RSI was under 30 at the moment, and going back up, it didn't go over 30 until a ways. I think we can slide this chart up, and you can see on the 60 minutes. So this was the buy at 636, and it ran up as high as 682, 536, and 682, so about 130 points was your maximum gain, a little bit more than that, depending on where you bought. But at any rate, it's an easy 100-point move anyway, and that's just what you're looking for. S3 quite often is a pivotal point. I mean, it's called a pivot point, but, you know, if it gets so oversold, it's S2 is getting oversold, and S3 is really oversold. Now, we said that we do have a trend line even lower if it went lower, but it looked pretty good there because it's 78.6, and when you look left, all that time, it was right around that lariat too. So, anyway, those are the things you look for if you're trading futures. If you want to make the bigger money or the safer bet, you wait for oversold, overbought conditions, RSI dropping under 70, going back up over 30 at a specific point that coincides with either pivots or Fibonacci's or both, and then you're in good shape. And also, if it's a trend line, can help a lot too. Okay, other ones we'll look at here. If I find my mouse, too many screens and it disappears, as you know. And the S&P 500 futures is 60 minute as well, as you can see. Also RSI skipped up over 30 right when it was at S3, which was also at 78.6, which you don't see here on this screen. And it bounced up pretty nice from there, and so that made a decent trade as well. Also, we can take a look at Boyle, B-O-I-L, which is the 2X ETF for natural gas, of course, and that's been our sweetheart. And it pulled back. Now, it wasn't an easy decision if you bought right there. It came in to the same level as it had been before. If you look left here, that was some support. Looking at the 60-minute candle, it had been support 1, 2, 3, 4 hours at least, and then it ran above it. So it held support. If you did buy it there, you could make it went up about 4 points. So that was a really a nice trade. And then it closed still over that 52. That's a support area as well. Maybe it can continue from there. Wanted to say it's about Apple because I believe they report on Tuesday after the close. It isn't this kind of parallel uptrending channel. Remember when they reported before and it ran up, it had drifted down before their earnings report, way down here to below 560. Then it gapped way up to like 620, and it just couldn't go any higher. It was just like, so it dropped down and made new lows again, and now it's gone up, and what? It can't break over the highs where it gapped up before. So doubtful that it's going to break out and make new highs above 640 in this summer market, but we'll see what happens after the report. If it does go up and can't break above, then that's going to be a short once again, because they don't want to come down and test to see if it can still maintain this channel. Now, there is a possibility that people do change and think it's great, whatever they're doing. Maybe they're going to announce something too. But anyway, here's the condition of it at the moment. Okay, now we'll get back to the what happened with stocks. We're not going to show you a lot of them. There were several on the watch list that continue. You can see that at our stock charts public page. But the only real buy, which we posted, was DHI. The volume was okay. It was just average volume. But when most of the market was down in the morning, this one stayed, and it actually hit above that little $19 trigger, and it didn't go up very far. It went to 19.30, but it closed over it. So it's a positive chart and kind of a down market. So if the market can change, this one could be a good continuation. You know, sometimes ones in the past that aren't too distant past, like GEN, mentioned this because some people, particularly in these low-priced ones, MB from the message board likes to trade some lower priced ones and hold them for, you know, months at a time if they start performing well. This is one that we had on the watch list for over $100.47. It broke out and ran up to the 50-day EMA, and then a couple weeks ago it came down to the above the original buy point is where it bounced to the 20-day, and it moved up. Anyway, if you held that for just 6 weeks, 8, whatever it's been, 2 months, less than 2 months. You did well as it gapped up another 25%. Now it's over the 200-day. When they do that and they gap way up above the Bollinger Band, it's a good idea to take some profits there, like maybe all of them, and then buy it when it comes back in again. It could gap again, but that's you have a chance to buy it again if you like the story. Just showing another one because we mentioned pharmaceuticals so many, and these are the space that get these wild moves like this, and this is one from the past as well. And you can see the 20 days just starting to go over the 200-day. Anyway, it had a big move up, 35% gain in the day. It isn't one of ours. It's just pointing out that that's still the group that's a lot of movement in their stem cells as well. And a lot of the stem cells are, you know, of course, they're speculative, and just pointing out that this one, stem, continued from, we pointed out last week, that it moved up and then dropped back down again. It broke out once again. Okay, so I think we'll just get to the additions to the watch list. We've got ASTI, and you can see it's got nice pattern here. It's consolidating in this area. It's also a low-priced stock, not high volume at the moment, 350,000 shares, so pay attention to that. So somewhere in this range or break above 128, just pay attention to these. If they have high volume, they can be big movers, as you see, sometimes in the leaderboard of gains of 15 or 20%. ELLI looks pretty interesting over that 1976, because you've got about a 75-cent gain if it goes back to test the 2054 high. Now, it needs volume. It's very light volume. Do pay attention. Note this, that it's a couple hundred thousand shares is all now. But it has that volume up at 3 million. And if we go back here to GEN, let me point some. When you see those big volume days, remember this one at the end of June had 2 million, then it went up to 3 million. Why was that? And it's moved up, but not a lot. Sometimes there's things that brewing that we don't know about. So when we look back at the GEN, you see that big volume, and it had like 50, 60 million shares back in June? It's huge. Someone thought something was up. Well, now you look at the day, 125 million. Someone got in back there, and they made some nice profits. Okay, up next, we just mentioned what ELLI, so now let's take a look at ETN. Now, the 50-day is 40.57, and what it closed at? 40.57. So it gets back over, I would say, the 40.65. That was the high, earlier high in July. That'd be all right. Its high of the day was 41.75. So if it goes back over that 40.65 and can only get to the high of the day, that's $1.10 as a quick trading profit, and had increased volume. So I think that's going to be trying some movement again. Can pull back a little bit as long as it stays above that 20-day. Then we have continued hope that it's going to try to move higher once again. HCSG is pulled back. Now it had a bit of a bounce from that area. You can see 21.91 was the high back in May, and then it pulled back, and it's moved back over that again in July. And so that was 21.91, and the low of the day was 21.95. Within 4 cents of that's where it bounced. It had high volume, which we don't like, but if your stop is going to be like the 21.90, 21.85, something like that, you may watch this one and see if it starts reversing with volume. It's Healthcare Services Group, and sometimes with these you can buy a little bit, and if it goes the wrong direction, just get out of it. If it goes the right direction and volume starts to increase, you can always add your position, then later start peeling off some you bought at the lower level. MMR we bought in the past at the breakout around that $10 area. It's moved up to 14, then it dropped back down to 10.94. Back recently it was up at 14 again. We're thinking about 13.60 if it has pretty good volume. From there it might go back up to 14.21. There's 60 cents profit just, and that's before a possible breakout. ROK looked kind of interesting, back over about 66 on high volume. Its high of the day was 66.50, but it had good volume and closed again fourth day in a row over the 20-day moving average, and that's the first time since in May. So I think that's moving above there can be a buy, at least to run to the 50-day. It's almost assuredly going to touch the 50-day if it has good volume, and that's a decent trade to start things off. Above there, we'll see. Keep some, sell some. TSO. over the line on good volume or quick short underneath. What more can we say? It's going to do one or the other. I don't know which. The volume was light. That's good on consolidation. Quite often when you see it drop like that and then flag, it drops one more time as well. But sometimes also it was just a quick rinse. It's been pretty strong, and then a move back up to follow. VMED over $25.35. Looks a pretty good setup. We'd like to have seen higher volume recently, but we haven't. But now all the ducks are in a row. We've got the 20-day, then, oh, we don't yet. We have the 20-day, then the 200-day, and the 50-day. It's got to move some more to get that 50-day above the 200-day, and then we're more bullish. But at the moment, it's pretty bullish, and we think we'll try for a breakout to come. WTR 26.95 had really good volume on Friday, light volume on Monday, consolidation. Let's see the reason for that big volume and a nice move over 26.93 to get things going. Anyway, that's what we got for the start of the week, on Tuesday, at least after the start of the week. So I hope you have a good day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you looked in the newsletter and saw the, if you had never seen, or even if you'd seen it before, Baraka, because that film is so, it's really a great film, and I look forward to his new film coming, starting in August at selected theaters. We posted a link to that, but that film's definitely worth watching. It's in the newsletter. So have yourself a good trading day. We'll be sending out tweets before the market opened and during the day also. So otherwise, we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas in Market Wrap. Thanks. Bye-bye.